Well, we're all a bit economy obsessed at the moment, but it often feels like there are a million of those indicators, indexes and gauges, call them what you will, tracking the health of the economy. Right now, depending on who you talk to, it's either pretty fit or a bit crook. But there's one measure in particular that we've taken a fancy to because, as 6:30's Max Futcher was delighted to discover, you can have it with a bottle of wine and a nice dessert.
The global markets are in turmoil.
The world is in a danger zone.
The Aussie dollar's sliding again. Geez, the Wallabies even lost to Ireland.
Hopes take a bit of a nosedive.
It can start to feel like the knives are out. So when all else fails, let's wine and dine.
I enjoy getting out of the office and meeting up with friends and colleagues. And just, yeah, having a break from the mundane office environment.
Give yourself a treat, I guess.
Yeah. just, we don't find it too expensive.
No matter how bad things are getting, we'll put off a new TV, even new shoes. But dinner with friends is staple.
Now, I think ultimately people are prioritising their lifestyle above some other things like shopping for retail clothing and fashion.
Nick Reed is ANZ's small business chief. The bank's figures from credit card receipts show spending at restaurants jumped 11% in the past year.
The trend has been going on for at least 3 to 4 months. Each month over the last 3 or 4 months, we've seen the trend of increasing sales through the restaurant sector going up a few percent each month.
And there's some obvious reasons. Food costs are rising, so cooking at home isn't as cheap. The rise of celebrity chef shows and cheap deals to get diners through the door.
That kind of thing is what everyone who are still in business had to do to survive.
Jim Barato is an institution in Noosa's restaurant scene. He says the start of the year was tough, but the foodies are coming back.
Well, I think all of our culture is based on food and eating, and most cultures, whether you're Italian or whether you're English, we all have to sit down at a table at one point in time, and there's no better way to enjoy friends and or family but than sitting down and having a great meal.
And they're walking in, sitting down and filling up. It's tipped Aussies will spend more than $19 billion this year at restaurants and cafes nationwide.
Catch up with friends as opposed to probably buying new things. So, yeah, happy to eat out. And Melbourne's a great place to eat out as well.
After finishing work, you don't feel like cooking so much, so you tend to buy out for ease of convenience.
It's not good news for the rest of the retail sector, but the fact is, you got to eat, and dining out with friends can be a mini holiday, pure escapism.
Just to get rid of it all and pretend you're in some exotic destination and for 3 or 4 hours and escape all those woes.
Why not? The world will be waiting when you get back.
Now, that's my kind of economic crisis.